So I went to my one, but because I have filmed like from my one downwards, I didn't have the intention of filming until we saw that some construction was going on and we had to divert into Obunabali. And then I saw this, like people's houses being sliced and partitioned for the new road. I have never witnessed something like this closely, so I was amazed and didn't recover fast enough before I remembered that, oh, let me show my YouTube friends. And then I just brought out my camera and started in the middle of nowhere. This is the link road between Obunabali, or through Obunabali, towards CFC and old GRA, not old GRA, yes, old GRA area. So this is what comes with development. I saw many houses that were just sliced into like three bedrooms that were remaining one room, maybe your parlor and one room. And some people were so fast to have reconstructed theirs and like plastered or covered the missing wall. But this thing just reminded me so much of when I was in Plateau State, Jos, and witness crisis. Like everyone was just looking destroyed, destroyed, destroyed. I don't know why it made me sad, but I just asked around and found out that everybody that was involved or affected were duly compensated, and I pray that is true. And of course, development is necessary, but God, this looks like, I don't know why it makes me so sad, but it's for a good cause. And hopefully, very soon it will be over, and I sincerely really pray and wish that everybody who was affected was compensated. So, I am just going to take this ride and show you what's going on here and how it looks. Peaceful, nice construction going on. You're just going to see that. So, we are passing through into Obunabali, then. Anyway, we'll end up towards Eastern Bypass roundabout. And then when we get to, what is it called? LNG. NLNG. LNG. LNG. Nigerian Liquefied Natural Gas. LN. Liquefied Nat. NG. LNG. LNG. LNG, 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 LNG. When we get to that LNG roundabout, then we are going to stop the vlog. But for now, I don't think I should say much. You're going to pass some notable places like the Ebus Pharmacy. Is that what it's called? We're going to pass a big St. Patrick's Hospital. And just ahead of us, there was one place, this very funny big car that was carrying drinks. The guy was trying to maneuver his way. He almost pushed that partition. This is the Ebus Pharmacy I was talking about. You know, the road divider. They poured sand just close to the road divider, but it wasn't compacted yet. So he now drove into that place and got stuck. And because there was already traffic on the road, so we were watching him try to get the car out of there. And I was just scared because if he forced himself out of there and doesn't hold his brake, if he leaves that place he's stuck, he's going to go straight towards us, even though we're like by the side. But his car was faced out of his lane, of course, towards our lane, and we're just in front of him. Like, Anyway, I just held the camera, although I had to fast forward that part because we were just stuck in traffic for hours, so I just fast forwarded it. But you can still look around and see what Obunabali looks like at this time. With the new road, and of course they are expanding the road, which is going to make it look sweet at the end. But development, oh boy, oh, change sometimes can be uncomfortable, but this is what it is. I've never witnessed where road expansion is happening and people had to be relocated or displaced in any way. So in case you find this video interesting, it is for you. Please don't skip the ads as you're watching. Ooh, that's a market. Was there a police station here? Oh, just at that market, I saw sewage company. Just exactly where the market is, there is a signboard there that says something sewage disposal. You can rewind a little to see it. It's just by the right there. See that signboard? sewage disposal services. So I don't know if the company, anyway, they might not be parking their car here or what. See, I don't want to go into it. Let's just look at the market and move on. So that guy, you're going to see his truck. I was telling my friend, because the car was filled with like soft drinks, like minerals, and I was like, damn, this guy that is driving this nonsense, if this car falls, anyway, it's not filled with beer. If it was filled with beer, people will come and enjoy themselves. But like with this mineral, oh, this is the car. Nobody is going to be interested except people that want to sell it. That's what Nigerians. Now, we don't bash Nigerians in this channel. But if your drinks are going to fall on the road, of course, your goods are insured now. Should be they are insured. So if people drink you, you'll still be reimbursed or whatever. Let's go. Hunger throat is not good. But we spent, let's say, about 40 minutes, 40 to 1 hour on this road in this 10 minute video you're seeing because of the hold up. And I wish I could like just patiently show you where some drivers were being really, really funny in an annoying way and just holding up the line for stupid reasons. If you drive and you feel as if you're one of those people that have sense when others don't have sense, and you would want to drive into the opposite lane. Oh God, I felt so bad for the construction workers here trying to control traffic because some human beings are gifted in looking for trouble. So we finally left here. We are approaching the, is it this time bypass? Yes, I don't know, but I like the sides. I like this left hand side. I was trying to see what was going on there, but there was a guy I filmed like this. I heard, can you see my phone in the picture, in the mirror? Like, people, you cannot film people in Nigeria without getting angry stares. You're not actually supposed to film people, but you know, like when I'm trying to get a location and then your car passes in front, the kind of stare people give you, God have mercy. Somebody cannot just look at you and smile and say hi and go. No, they'll be looking at you as if, you know. I try not to film people, but it happens sometimes. And this road, I think they've already worked here for a while. This road was tarred before now. Wasn't this road tarred? See, places in Port Harcourt confuse me. It's just because of these videos I try to film now. So when I am editing them and I have to watch it, like in the course of editing the video, I see places that I've never noticed and just pay more attention. So I'm beginning to know. See, yeah, the way I feel like a badass. And I, before, this road used to confuse me. See this Eastern Bypass side, where one goes to Odiare, one goes to, where does Eastern Bypass, that Eastern, see guys, just watch. So actually I have nothing to say again. Actually, I have nothing. Let me just see guys what has been happening in Port Harcourt. So for like 2 weeks it has been raining like crazy. That kind of every time rain that we start from like 3 a.m. and stop around 3 p.m. That kind of rain. And then about 1 week ago, previously it was raining like that. About 1 week ago, it now stopped. How it rains now is, it is going to rain heavy, as if the rain is angry at somebody, for like 1 hour, especially in the afternoons. When I mean heavy, flooding worries everybody that is prone to flooding. Just 1 hour rain, very heavy, angry, aggressive rain for like 1 hour, and then it stops, and then we enjoy peace and no rain until maybe the next day or next 2 days. So I was talking to somebody that is very elderly that wasn't around, and he was like, what's going on in Port Harcourt? And I explained the rain situation. He was like, oh, that the rain is, that shows that the rainy season is coming to an end. So maybe, but you know, it rains longer here than most part of the country, so you know, it's okay. So we just passed Eastern Bypass. We are heading to the Nigerian Liquefied Natural Gas, Nigerian Liquefied Natural Gas, LNG roundabout. We are almost there. And thank you for watching. Share this video with anybody who you know will be interested in this. I actually sent a voice note to a friend today and decided to bless this person with my sweet voice singing. I even hit a high pitch and the person was like, is that why you want to blind my ears? Blind my ears. Is that why you want to blind my ears? Even insulted. Let me sing for you guys. Bye, bye, bye. Bye.